We see 40,000 visits a month at the JCC. I hear 40,000 stories a month at the JCC.
Unfortunately, my earlier life is a little sad to hear because I am a survivor from the war. And when the war broke out, I was a child. 39, the Russians came in. 41, the Germans came in. Of course, then life became a horror. You don't want to hear the whole story. It's too gruesome.
It's much more than a gym. It's a connection, it's a bond, and it's a link to vitality for all of these women.
All my different friends, we meet after gym too sometimes. We go out together, we eat, we have fun. So to me, the friendship means a lot. I feel very comfortable here. When I come in, I say, hello, where have you been? You haven't been to the pool for a while. What happened to you?
I have known her for 18 years, and I want to know her forever.
It's been a long time.
Whatever is going on in the world, however tempted we are to despair, look at this sense of hope and future that is staring us in the face in every place the JCC offers programs for families with young kids.
I grew up out in Seattle, Washington, so our family is all very far away from us. It's not easy having everybody so far away. I really wanted to find a community of moms going through the same thing that I was going through. I knew that we would find people. It was a matter of where. And so I was relieved and excited that that place was going to be the JCC. I really feel like the six of us, there are core six women who started this group, we're going to be in touch for a long time. We're a family. When it came time for Rosh Hashanah dinner, it was just an emotional time to, you know, go from, oh gosh, I don't know what we're going to do for Rosh Hashanah dinner, to, of course you're coming to my parents' house with my sisters and their kids. And, you know, it was really special.
It's our job as a Jewish community center to listen to the lives of the people we aspire to serve.
We had talked to Diane Salzberg, and she told us about this place that Ellery can go to learn social interactions as well as just camp activities.
We accept children on the autism spectrum, Down syndrome, children with communication disorders.
Ellery has autism, and so the social part of making friends is so difficult.
Well, I do like taking photography, and I do like arts and crafts.
When Ellery first came to camp, he was very shy, kept his head down a lot. Just wanted to stay out of the line of fire. You could just tell he did not want to be spotlighted in any way. But little by little, you know, he tried things. He liked to swim. He liked to do sports.
Eventually, he found something in photography. I think that outlet is one of the ways he uses to express himself. Ellery has learned so much in terms of social interaction, appropriate social interaction. And let me tell you, he learned self-confidence there.
When Ellery one day played the saxophone at a talent show.
The song I played is a couple old songs.
There must have been probably 400 kids there, the whole upper camp. And spontaneously, when he finished, they just all stood up and gave him a standing O.
The audience cheered.
Did that make you happy?
Yes, it made me happy that I did.
Someone like Ellery teaches every day at camp for the 5-year-old or the 7-year-old or the 9-year-old who meet Ellery they forever understand the Jewish value of the infinite dignity of every human being as part of the community. And they learn it because they know Ellery.
If there was no Camp Grossman, he would not have been able to grow into such a fine young man that he is today.
Everyone who walks through our turnstile into our building, into a program, has a story that compels them to be there. Every individual is irreplaceable. Ellery and Tanya and Yael represent each and every one of us and our community and our families and our stories and our past and our present and our future.